getting our vaccines.
It costs thousands of dollars.
So we're feeling a little out of it and a little weird.
This is our last few moments here in Copenhagen. So we're gonna take a taxi to the boat, take a boat across to the mainland, take a bus to the bus terminal, and then get another bus. Will bring us all the way to Bangkok. I don't know if we're ready for this, but to be fair, we've had longer bus rides with more ferries. So I think it'll be fine. Love, are you excited? We are here waiting for our next bus, which should take us all the way to Bangkok, and we've got our tickets. Some stickers. The bus just dropped us off right on the main street here, and a bunch of taxi guys waiting to take us somewhere, but we don't even know where we're going, so we're just gonna walk. Well, we found a little place to stay for our first night in Bangkok. It's really pretty simple. Just beds, a desk to work at, and a little private bathroom. We're not really sure if this is where we're gonna be for our whole week in Bangkok, because it's okay. But for now, they let us check in super early. It's 8 o'clock, so that was nice. And there's a restaurant and things downstairs. So for now, it's good enough.
Love this.
Mine is new too. Crispy pork. Yes. Good morning.
Bon dia.
We are on a mission today to go get our vaccines for travel.
We get the bus. Early in the morning.
Traffic.
Yes.
All right, so we arrived here at the hospital. That was not a bad bus ride, about 40 minutes, but heavy traffic, but that's expected at 7:30 in the morning.
It's not far, but because of traffic, yeah, take a long time.
Yeah. So yeah, we're here getting our vaccines. To get the same vaccines in Japan, where we're based, would be a couple thousand dollars for both of us. So here in Thailand, it's much, much cheaper than that. But that means, yeah, we're gonna be maybe a little under the weather for the rest of the day, at least.
The week.
Yeah, maybe the week. Let's see how it goes. Hopefully it's all smooth. Okay, well, we just got back from getting our vaccines, so we're feeling a little out of it and a little weird, but we decided to move hotels today. This one is okay, but not the best, and we found one that's in a nice location that should be a little better to just rest for the rest of the week. So we're gonna take a taxi because we're tired, and then just... 3 floors up. Only stairs.
Smells good. Yes.
nice bathroom. Oh, I like it's a little separated.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's pretty big. Nice.
A little desk, a little balcony, a little TV.
And look. I can stay here and relax.
Yeah.
For long.
This is where we're gonna be sick for a while.
I feel I have fever already.
Yeah, let's get our stuff down and sleep.
Well, we checked into our new hotel. We're really tired because we got all 5 of our vaccines done today. Well, not all of them. We've still got more to do in the future, but we've got the first round done. So we got
yellow fever, rabies, Japanese encephalitis, cholera, and what's the last one?
Polio?
Typhoid?
One more. That was a mix of a couple different ones. So, our arms hurt?
Yeah, the Japanese encephalitis one really hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, the rabies one hurts.
Mm. My arm is okay. We got 2 in each arm.
Yeah.
And the cholera one is like you drink it, like a straw.
Nama vaccine, live one to drink.
Yeah.
I like it.
It was tasted awful. Terrible.
For me, it was like tastes like a chicken. And the nurse asked how it was. I said, like chicken flavor thing. And she said, like a chicken soup. And I said, oh, yeah, tastes like that.
I had to drink water immediately after. I couldn't finish it. Yeah. But overall, not too bad. And then we're going to have to come back after 1 week to finish some of the vaccines. Cholera and rabies, we need to do one more time. And there's a couple others, like hepatitis, which we needed to do a blood test for before we could get them. So we can do that again as well.
Yeah. Today we get the blood test to check if we already have the hepatitis in our body or not. So we'll be decided if we need or not to get the vaccines.
Yeah. And that's all going to happen in a couple weeks. We have to wait 2 weeks for cholera, and we can wait more for hepatitis and rabies, so we might as well just wait for that. So we're going to spend a couple days recovering here in Bangkok, and then probably explore a little Chiang Mai, maybe somewhere north of there, renew my visa, do those things, and then come back to Bangkok for the second round of vaccines. By the way, if you're confused about why we're doing vaccines in Thailand, basically, in Japan, it costs thousands of dollars to do your vaccines for traveling, and that's just, I don't know, a little too much to spend. Whereas here, we spent already about $300.
Yes, something like that.
For each person?
No, for both.
We will spend about $300 per person. At the end of everything.
And if we take in Japan, it would be like 10 times or more expensive, like 100 yen ぐらい for both. Yeah.
So Japanese healthcare is really good, but they don't pay for things that are unnecessary. And they consider travel unnecessary. And so the vaccines required for travel are also unnecessary. That extends even to like things like pregnancy and stuff like that. Your insurance doesn't cover any of that. So, yeah, most of the things in Japan are good that way, but it's a little bit cheaper here. Now, it's a little risky to start traveling without getting the vaccines done first.
Yeah, especially rabies in Southeast Asia. A lot of stray dogs, and I think 3 years ago, have some like case, Japanese guy gets rabies working in Philippines. So in Philippines, it was like extra careful to... We love puppies, but to not be so close. But it was pretty okay. We was taking care. And now we have our vaccines.
Yeah, well, kind of, almost finished.
Yeah.
By the way, if you don't know, rabies is
uncurable. So it's the one that really scares me. A lot of the other ones, you'll get really sick and you can spread it and that's bad, but rabies is the really scary one, I think. But yeah, hopefully that won't be an issue.
Yes.
Also, yellow fever was required for Juli as a Brazilian, but we got really lucky coming in through Malaysia. They mentioned that she needed it, but...
Yeah, it was really scary. We didn't talk about it, but from Singapore to Johor, when we crossed the border, like, I take, like, yeah, longer. The guys was asking me, or you're Brazilian, or your yellow card, the yellow fever vaccine, but I tried to explain, I live in Japan for all my life, and we plan to take the vaccines in Thailand, and he think. He'd go and talk to some guys, and he let me inside. But I think for Brazilians, like for I think South America people traveling Southeast Asia, many countries ask for the yellow fever. And the doctor today actually was surprised too, like how you could come to Thailand without your yellow card. And from Malaysia to here, Thailand, we take a ferry. Port to and
they didn't ask anything.
Yeah, I think if we come by air plane at airport, they will be more strict and maybe not let me in Thailand. But yeah, now I'm today I get my yellow fever and I have my yellow card.
Yeah, so we're pretty much that also is going to be important if we decide to leave Thailand and come back. For visa reasons or for travel reasons. So now that is all taken care of.
Yes. Yellow card, saying our yellow fever get and the first cholera.
It's just the first dose. Yes.
The travel one is the same. And another one, so we get this from the Red Cross.
This is more like just keeping track of what we've already got.
Yeah. Rabies is here. Oh, so there we get.
Tetanus, diphtheria.
And polio. Mm. This is Japanese encephalitis. Yeah. It.
So, these are going to stay with us now. And we can prove that we're vaccinated.
Yes. Yeah, I don't know how much is in America, but if we start our trip in Brazil, I know in Brazil we'll be all free. And in Thailand is already way cheaper than we will spend in Japan. And it's good to know. Yeah. Ontem foi dia dos namorados e como ontem nós também tomamos muita vacinas. Dormimos o dia todo. Eu dormi o dia todo, o Trevor ficou jogando game, descansando. Então hoje, dia 13, vamos comemorar o dia dos namorados. Ainda eu estou um pouquinho ruim, por isso hoje só também ficamos aqui no hotel, descansando, trabalhando um pouquinho, online. Mas encomendamos pizza! E o Trevor chegou com a nossa pizza.
It smells so good.
Oh my god, the size is good.
Let's see. It's like a real pizza.
And we ordered like 20 minutes ago, like 10 minutes ago.
It's pretty fast.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, the shop is like 12-minute walk from here, but because you're still a little sick, we order and for celebrate the Brazilian couple's days. Feliz dia dos namorados.
Feliz dia dos namorados.
Eat some pizza. Let's try this vodka pie. Is they say like, it's some special tomato sauce?
Yeah, vodka-based tomato sauce and mozzarella. Oh my god. Oh, it's really good.
good.
Oh, it's amazing.
Oh my god, I'm so excited. Gallery pizza. I read the comments, many people say it's the best pizza in Bangkok too.
Good afternoon!
What, Archie?
We are still recovering from our vaccines, just hanging out here, still feel a little bit sick, but we need to do something fun in Bangkok that is very Bangkok, so tonight we're going to a cabaret show. We're excited. I'm not sure if we can actually film inside. We're gonna try a little and definitely take some pictures. But yeah, we've gotta go like now. So let's head over there.
Yeah!
That was really fun.
Yeah.
We got a few shots, but we had to film with the phone, so the quality is not as good. But yeah, it was a cool little experience. I think the one we went to was the cheaper option, but it was still really worth it. The costume's really cool. The the songs were really nice. Nobody was actually singing, but yeah. That's fine.
It was really fun. It's not like a professional like theater performance, so don't expect it, but the experience, it's worth it.
Good afternoon.
What are you?
Well, this is actually our last day in Bangkok, this time. So we're gonna definitely come back in about a week or so, but and do more sightseeing that time, I hope.
We need.
But this is our last night this time, so we're gonna do a little bit of sightseeing tonight. We're gonna go to the flower market and check out the area near there. Yeah, don't know what to expect, but hopefully get some good pictures.
And Chinatown.
And Chinatown. I don't know how well it shows up on camera, but this temple is like the perfect lighting right now, and it's literally sparkling. It's really cool. Good morning.
Bon dia.
It is 5:30, and we are getting ready to head out and leave Bangkok, at least for now. Also, last night was really fun, but our GoPro battery died while we were out there. So hopefully we've got some good shots, but we'll see.
Yeah. Now, 10-hour bus ride.
Next stop, Chiang Mai. It's a lot further than we were thinking.
It's far.
But fortunately, we can catch the 7 o'clock bus and should be there by about 7 o'clock or so. So, yeah, not too bad. It's not the longest bus ride we've ever been on, but
yeah.
It's longer than our recent bus rides. Should be comfy though.
Yeah.
But yeah, Bangkok, we've been kind of just hanging out. It's been actually really nice to be here, but we definitely have to come back, well, one, to get more vaccines, but also definitely see a little bit more of the sights and the different areas of Bangkok. But that's for another time. For now, we're off to Chiang Mai. So, in the meantime, thank you very much for watching, and
see you at our next destination.
Ciao.